Understanding clinical studies. The Vertis pediatric study, 10 to 17 year olds. This video is being used for informative purposes only and does not depict a patient's actual experience. This video is not intended to replace the informed consent and assent forms. Please see the informed consent and assent forms for important information about this study. Hey Janet, what is this?
Oh, that is a brochure my doctor gave my parents. It has information about a clinical study called the Vertis Pediatric Study that I will be participating in.
A clinical study? What is that?
My doctor told us that a clinical study happens when scientists and doctors would like to see what happens after you join a study. During the study, they will give you a study medication and see how it works in your body. This clinical study is being done to test a study medication that may help children who have type 2 diabetes. Some children who are in the study will get active study medicine, which is called ertugliflozin, or MK8835. Other children in the study will get a lookalike pill that does not have active study drug. This way, the doctors can compare the two groups. I don't know which group I'll be in, and the doctor will not know either. That way, both groups will be treated fairly. They can find out which group I'm in if there is an emergency.
Wow, that is interesting. Why are they doing this study in children?
Adult bodies work differently than children's and teens' bodies. That means adult medications may not work the same way in us. So clinical studies in children and teens are needed to find out if the study medicine works and if it is safe for us too. This clinical study is for children who are 10 to 17 years old and have type 2 diabetes. Because I am under 18, the study doctor first had to get permission from my parents. She told them about the study and said I might be a good candidate for the study. My parents were interested, so they signed a form called the Informed Consent Form, giving the study doctor permission to have me join the clinical study. The Informed Consent Form has more details about the study, and it also lists all the potential side effects that can happen while I'm in the study. I also had to sign a form like the Informed Consent Form called the Informed Assent Form. By signing this, I agreed to participate in a clinical study. Then the doctor examined me, took my weight and measurements, and drew my blood to run some tests. A few days later, the doctor called my parents and told them I qualify for the study. So I went to the doctor's clinic to start the study medication. If I did not qualify for the study, nothing would have happened to me. I would still be treated by my doctor for type 2 diabetes. I would also have just continued to take my regular diabetes medication, and I would not have been able to participate in the Vertis pediatric study.
What are the potential side effects that can happen while you're in the study?
The study doctor said it is possible to get headaches, get yeast infections on my private parts, get urinary tract infections and wee more than usual, have itching of my private parts, feel thirsty, lose too much body water, dehydration, and have low blood sugar, hyperglycemia, if I'm also taking insulin. I may feel other side effects, and I will tell my parents and the study doctor if I feel unwell.
Okay, so what do you have to do while you're in the study, and how long will you be participating?
The study will last about 14 months, and I will have to go to the study doctor's office about 8 times. During that time, the study doctor will give me the study medication to take home to treat my type 2 diabetes. While I'm home, I will have to take the study medication every day and any other medication that I am taking. I will also measure my blood sugar levels every day using a glucose meter and then write it down in a logbook for the study doctor to review at my next visit. The study doctor will give me the logbooks at the beginning of the study and throughout the study if needed. I must also follow all the instructions given to me by the study doctor. For example, it is important that I continue to eat healthy and exercise. For some of my visits, I must not eat, drink anything other than water, take the study medication or any of my other diabetes medication within 10 hours of the study doctor's visit. I should also bring to each of the visits all remaining study medication, my diabetes medications, the glucose meters I use to measure my blood sugar level, and the logbooks.
Cool. What happens if you don't want to participate anymore?
Being in the study is up to me. I can stop taking the study medication at any time. Even if I choose to stop taking the study medication, I can still be part of the study, so the research team can contact me for follow-up on my type 2 diabetes. If I choose to continue the study, even after stopping the study medication, the doctor will continue to examine me, take my weight and measurements, and draw my blood to run some tests.
Wow, this is so interesting, Janet. Thanks for telling me about the Vertis Pediatric Study.
You're welcome, Rodrigo. Now back to our movie.